Hello everyone, thanks for tuning in again. I have a video out from a long time ago that showed users and people who owned a Google Home how to play iTunes or Apple Music with their Google Home. Now, today I'm going to show you how the Google Assistant can go ahead and play the iTunes or the Apple Music. Now, the reason I'm making this video is I'd actually been getting a lot of comments on the channel that people couldn't make this work. So I wanted to go out, test it out again, make sure it worked, and refresh a little bit with the new interfaces. So here you go. Let's get your Google Assistant working with your Apple Music. Let's start out with some of the commands coming right from the Google support page for Google Assistant. You can play songs, artist, album, or genre or a mood, or you can just ask for personalized suggestions, just ask it to play some music. You can pause or stop, resume, next, previous, and you can ask questions about what's playing if you don't know it. Of course, you can change the volume, you can increase and decrease, or you can set a level or percentage like we see with the Google Home product. Now, this only works for iTunes or Apple Music on an iPhone or an iPad. So I'm going to show you how to set that up now on your iPhone. Now, the one thing you will need for Apple Music is you will need a subscription. So you've got to go into the settings on your phone. You actually have to go into the iTunes and App Store section, and then you have to tap on your Apple ID up at the top. Obviously, I've blanked mine out for good reason here, but once you go into that, you're going to see a section for subscriptions down below. Tap on that and make sure that it says Apple Music, and at least it shows you an individual music membership. You could have a family membership, you could have the student one, all of those will work too, but you do have to have this. If you don't, this will not work. So now moving over to the Google Assistant application here, and I'm just going to tap up at top right the little compass icon, and then I'm going to tap on the three dots up at the top and go to settings. I'm going to scroll down. You can see my device, my iPhone, but I'm going to tap on music at this time. Once in there, you can see the different music services that are available. You could choose any one as the default. You could choose no default if you wanted. So down at the bottom, you're going to see Apple Music. Now, I'm using an iOS 11.x device here that allows me to do all of this. So I have an updated Google Assistant application and my iPhone device is iOS 11. Now skipping over to the Google Assistant itself, all I have to do is tap on the little microphone icon at the bottom. I'm going to ask it to play royalty-free music and you'll see the assistant respond, sure, it's asking Apple Music. Now, let me show you. I'm going to mute the mic on my Google Home just so it doesn't trigger as I do this, but what's really funny about this demo is I'm actually connecting to an Amazon Echo Plus. I could do the same thing with the Google Home, and then I would also have the Google Home Alexa and its capability for controlling
connect
music.
To my phone.
Searching. Now connected to Ryan's iPhone.
Hey Google, play royalty-free music on Apple Music. Next song. Volume down.
Okay.
So there you go. Your Google Assistant is all connected and you can use Bluetooth to connect to any Bluetooth speaker, let alone the Echo Plus that I used in this video. You could obviously use the Google Home as well and from that point use it to control your Google Assistant and your Apple Music. So you could actually pair using Bluetooth to your Google Home and then use the same set of commands to control Apple Music
through your Google Home right there. So go ahead, guys, try that out. Leave any comments below if you're having trouble. Obviously, this is going to take an iPhone for it to work. You're going to have a relatively updated iPhone as well. So there you have it, everyone. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.